Hello, it's Keith from KMAs Korner. How you doing? I am back on the Athens server, and we got some things to do today. But first, let's go feed some people and put on my broken armor. Wrong side. I don't even know my castle. Today, a little while ago, a few months ago, somebody had mentioned to me, "Hey Keith, you're a musician. You like note blocks. Why don't you do something with note blocks?" Well, guess what? Today is that day. Because look. Oh yeah. Oops, but where am I going? I want to go over here. I was in the middle of doing something when I decided to restart recording this. So I haven't fed these people yet. I don't think. Hello, guys. I spent a lot of dough on you, and I have yet to be breeding you, really. I only have three. Yeah, see, I only bred them once since I've been over here. Let's get some of these guys going, too. Might as well, while I got the wheat and get all of those. I'm gonna put this stuff away. And I'll show you what I'm gonna do. And how I do note blocks. We might do a little work afterwards. Just depending on how long this takes to record. I know note block work is not fun. But we'll see. I'm not gonna say anything special. I replaced the little, I made a stripe in here just to brighten things up a little. And for those who you didn't see, this is my little place. And I was complaining about diamonds earlier. I had totally forgotten that I had a storage chest with diamonds in it. So all this stuff is increased a little bit more. I didn't bring over the gold or the iron, but I do have plenty of diamonds, so I can replace or fix these worn down things pretty soon. I love bouncing my head off this. It's so much fun. So, ow, I'm gonna have to start wearing a helmet. Oh, come on. There we go. It's funny, 90% of the times I can get out of there the first try, but every time I record, not a chance in hell. So, we got plenty of sunshine. So here's the dirt room where all these note blocks are gonna go. And what I do, oh, I hope I get grass underneath this whole thing. That would be awesome. I made this in Creative World first and tested it out, found out exactly how much space, the layout and all that, and make sure the song works. So what I do is I choose a song that I want. And in this case, it's "Oh What a Beautiful Morning" from the play from Oklahoma and the movie. And I used to listen to it on CBS This Morning, I think. I don't know if they still use it because I don't watch the news anymore. But they use the melody in that. And I kind of like it. It's positive. I was depressed at the time watching news, and depression kind of go together. That song kind of lifted me up a little bit, even though it was the news. And, woohoo! We're gliding along. So, you get the melody. You can open up Minecraft Noteblock, the actual wiki page, and there's a picture of a keyboard, if you don't know music, and it has all the letters that go with each key on the keyboard. And each letter is also numbered. So if you can figure out which one key and it's a number that it goes with, you can find out the numbers for all the notes. So you don't even have to really worry about the notes. And what I do is I take a melody and find out where it fits on that keyboard. And then I find the lowest note on that and I move everything down to the lowest note, which is the F sharp, which is number 0. And then go with the melody from there. Because I think the higher piano sounds on this game sound worse than the lower notes. And I'm not doing anything special other than just piano sounds. Yeah. I don't know how it's powering it here, so I'm just going to take that away for now. I know the melody, and what I do, I don't know how much into music this is going to get into, but I use each repeater to equal a quarter note in music. So if I needed a half note, oops, which is double the quarter note, I put the repeater on the longest setting, because each quarter note is a repeater at the longest setting. That would be a 32nd note, an 18th note, an 8th note, then the quarter note. So if I needed a half note, it would be two of them. And if I needed a whole note, it would be four, because two halves make a whole. Duh, geometry. So that's kind of how I think of the repeaters. So I told you how to get the notes and how to vary them out. So if you get the sheet of music and you can know what an eighth note looks like, or you can get like a on the wiki page, a beginner music thing, it will tell you which note is which. It will let you know how many repeaters to use. But I'm not really going to get into it that much here. So I think in the head, oh, what? I need a second thing. Each one of these note blocks is a note. Tiff, full, mourn, and that note is actually the length of three, so I'm gonna put down three repeaters here, just so I know. Ning, and also is a longer note. So, three repeaters. So each one of these first notes here are all quarter notes. So that means I set this to four, so there's a four variance on here. I know it might be kind of confusing. And these last two are actually the length of three quarter notes. So, we're gonna set these to the length of three quarter notes. So if I made a pulse, can I just put a button right on the note block? Let's see. I don't know why it sounds like it's slowing down somewhere, but anyways. Let's try and put the notes in. So I correspond the notes to the particular number. So in this particular thing, the first note is 8. 1, 2, well actually let's start it from the very beginning. If I'm not sure if I might have right clicked it already, I just pick it up again, replace it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The next note is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one stays the same. This one's a 1. Next one is a 5. 4, 5, 8. And you know what I did? I was off with this. I've missed a note. So I'm just gonna go at it like this. 11. You see how the higher that gets, the worse it sounds? And actually, I was right. I don't know why I picked those up. So, let's get up here. 1, 2, 3. We can put this one down. And this one's a 10. Two, three again. So, I'm hoping this will work on the server. It was sounding kind of weird the first time I was trying it. And I don't know if that was because of the server or what. Where'd my button go? Or it could have been because of the button. It sounds like this one doesn't want to play. Let's replace it, see what happens. Could it be because of the torch? Is that a thing? Whoa. Let's see, which one was it? This one? So it's a third note, which is zero. Okay. Let me put the torch one higher. Okay, so that's the first melody. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna finish this up and come back and play the whole thing for you. And that is gonna be my sunshine song. So, let me get to sleep real quick. And I'll be back. All right, I'm back. It is done. Let's give it a listen. So there it is. It is done. Let me show you what every repeater has every note block has a repeater going into it. We can follow it, I guess, maybe. So as you see, the last one was two notes because there's two note blocks next to each other. And as you see in the rest of this, no two note blocks are next to each other. They're diagonal to each other. So that's how you get them to go separately. And you use repeaters so you don't cross the signals, because if I were to put a redstone dust right there, it would do both of these. So that's the trick. And seeing that music is pretty much even based, you can do this pretty easily just by starting your one block up. So the hardest thing about doing this is just when you can't count up right and you just miss it by one and you know it's off and you're just trying to find where it is. But making all these note blocks, I have run out of wood, so that's what we're gonna do next. Before we get some wood, I wanted to show you this. I don't know if I ever recorded this. This is something I made in the Stark Oak Forest. It's kind of like a home. Nothing special. It's got the brown, and we got a little fishing dock here. I rather like it. Oh, look at this. We're gonna take that with me. The problem I had... Oh, and there's the front that has my banners. And basically the bottom is just I drew these trees all around the corner. I think four of them in a row, four of them that way, four in that way. Cut out the center and made it into a house. Then, for the second floor, what I did was I grew another set of trees on top of that and had the second tier. That's why this is so high. I was thinking of doing the, you know, like four or five high, but I could never make it look good. And I just wanted a quick house. So that's what this was. So I came over here because I actually had no dark oak, and I didn't even have any, any saplings of dark oak, so that's why I came over here. And the end is actually down here, this community mine, but see the end downstairs, and we'll go there someday. But I'm gonna go back and get some more trees. Gotta love that. I kind of forgot all about that. So what we could do now is just a little bit of this. Actually, let's grow something bigger. I need lots of wood. Each one of those note blocks was eight planks, so two of these logs. And I don't know, there's lots of them. I'm kind of having a hard time deciding what to do in this series. I'm just thinking right now which projects to do in the future. Eventually I will make a nighttime song. Not like copying what Etho did, but I think hearing that song has always kind of cheered me up, so just hearing it now is kind of cool. So I'm really happy I made it. Oops. And maybe I'll do a tutorial for people who are musically uninclined and who want to do this also. It is kind of complicated, especially if you don't know anything about music, but it is definitely learnable, and to me, a lot of it's the redstone's not difficult. You just get to know divisions well. And what I mean, just everything's based on fours, and it's all math. So if you're good with math, you can learn how to do this stuff. I just wanted to give you a heads up. Last night, I released a video, or I should be releasing a video, explaining about a very difficult thing that's happened, which basically, we got pretty much scammed by a loan company. And when it happened, we were on the edges of needing a loan, and then my job forgot to pay me for a couple of days, 1 week, and it takes 2 weeks for that to be fixed. So I was short money, so we decided, well, we're gonna have to get a loan now because job screwed up. And so what we did, we did some research on some loan companies, and we found one that was good. And we went online, went onto their website, and applied for a loan. And we got a phone call, and we gave them our bank account number, our routing number, all the information they needed, a copy of my license, back and forth. And it turns out that the people who were running that website were running a mock imitation site. And it wasn't the loan company, it was a couple of random guys from New York City. And before we had figured this out, they got all our information, including our bank account number and all that good stuff. So we were in the process of figuring out what happened when I recorded the other video, and it's been a little while since I recorded last night's video, and now we have more information on what's going on. Initially, the thought was is that they drained our bank account, we had no money left, we had no food, and all that non-good heebie-jeebie. But now, after we've done some research, it looks like they were only looking for the initial fee. They had us do something which was strange to me, but sometimes when you're in need of something really badly, you overlook the obvious, the obvious things that make it look kind of scammy, because you are looking for the outcome so badly, so you kind of deny the fact that this might actually be a scam, and you kind of go, nah, I trust this, yeah. And one of the things that was kind of scammy is they wanted us to prepay them. Before, I'm sorry, something's going on with my cat out there. And I just wanted to make sure it wasn't my daughter needing something. What they wanted us to do was to prepay them some money to prove that we could actually pay the money back when we got it. And I'm like, that's kind of weird. But it was kind of like, what are we going to do? We're screwed if we don't get money in our... goal was on the destination, and we didn't care about the journey, and the journey is what got us. So we kind of didn't play it smart at all. What the, this is a itty bitty tree. But it turns out all they were looking to get at was our pre-money. So they actually only got away with like maybe $500. And the possibility to sell our information to somebody else. But since then we have changed our bank account number. We put a fraud alert back on my credit because a few years ago somebody had tried to take my what type of tree is that? Somebody tried to take my identity, and so we put a fraud alert on it. But in the past 2 years we've bought 5 cars, and let me tell you, if you have a fraud alert on your credit, buying cars and so forth is a real pain in the ass. So we took that off, figuring that all that stuff was gone. But that is back on again because this guy does have my license number. He does not have my social. But I'm thinking if the guy worked so hard to get money up front, that they actually, why would somebody work so hard to get money up front if they're actually going to try and get our bank account and drain it? So we were able to change our bank accounts and all that just in case they were going to drain it. So we're actually pretty safe. We're kind of in a sucky place. We had to make a deal with the landlord. We have still not really enough money to buy food after we pay the important bills like keeping our electric and our cable on. We gotta have our internet and cable, you know. So it's looking good. So even though it's a sucky, the sucky ain't as sucky as I thought it was gonna be. It's only partially sucky. So I'm rather happy about that. So if you are ever going for a loan, some things that you should look out for. I found out afterwards that people can't do loans strictly on the phone in America. So if you're not meeting with somebody face to face, it is illegal for them to give you a loan. So if you didn't meet with somebody, don't go get a loan from them. And I kind of actually knew this beforehand, but the loan, it was such an easy process, and I was thinking that they were kind of bending the rules and we needed the loan bad, and I was just like, kind of, yeah, let's just get the money so we can pay a couple of bills and get on with our lives, and then we can get the money that my job owes me next week and we can get back on track. So don't do that. Make sure. Another thing that they do, if you have to pay money before you receive money, that's a sure sign that it's a scam also. So we paid them money before we got the loan, and that was a sure sign. And we were also so worried about the people. I'm gonna do the good old F5. We were so sure about these people, unsure, that we actually called up the initial company that we thought they were and said, hey, we got some people working out of New York for you guys. Do you have a New York office? And they're like, no, we don't have a New York office. We never heard of these guys. These guys sound like scam artists. But unfortunately, sometimes you need things and you're so blinded because you want something so bad. We kind of denied the fact that that happened and we went along with it. Don't be stupid like that. Use your head. I was using my head, but I was just so blinded. I looked at all the different things that make a scam company a scam company, and 8 out of 10 of them, they were part of it. And I'm like, and we were kind of like, we need this money so bad that it was almost like, let's risk the $300 to get it. And, you know, we risked it and we lost it and we got kind of screwed and we're learning our lesson and we were acting stupid and all that great stuff. So I kind of just giving you guys a heads up. We have a food bank. Yeah, We make too much money to normally get money from a food bank, but we have a food bank that we have helped, and they know that we have helped them, and we've even bought refrigerators, you know, full, you know, $400 fridges for these for people to help them out during tough times. So they know that we are going through a tough time, and even though they're really initially not supposed to help us, they're going to give us some food that we may not have to finish off the week before the pay period. So what comes around goes around. Always be nice to the people around. Always try and help out those that are a little less off than you. And when shit hits the fan like it did for our lives these past couple of days, thank you for stop making that noise. When shit hits the fan, you have people there that will support you because you've done good things yourself to other people. So karma does exist. Even though this is a shitty situation, a lot of good stuff has happened from it. So I'm going to take a nap, and we're going to listen to my song and call it an episode. I love this song. It makes me happy. Goodbye, it's Keith. Have a good day. See you next week, next Sunday, on the Athens server.